go, guys. Dropped down yesterday morning for the Gardener Social at Burfield Blue Pool. It was a quiet night. Heard a few fish boshing about in front of me, but nothing happened till this morning, and I've just managed to snare this little beauty. She's taken on a cotton rig, an old faithful rig of mine that I've been using for a number of years, and we'll get her back to her home, and I'll run you through the rig. Right, so now I'm going to run you through the actual items that I use to tie this rig and how to tie this rig. So to start with, hook link material is the Trickster Heavy. I like the camo brown. Reason I use this, you want, for this rig, you want it to be as supple as you can possibly get, just so the bait behaves naturally. What you use with it is a critically balanced wafter. So that's going to act naturally, and the softer the material you use, the more natural it's going to react. So I'll take off probably about 18 inches to start. Just tied a loop for your hair, and add your wafter. Now obviously check the balance on this, because the wafters are going to vary slightly. And you can just pinch a little bit off of your wafter until it balances. What you want is you want your hook laying flat on the bottom and the bait just wafting just up above it. So we'll slide that on. So there's your bait on to start. Now this is probably the most important part of the rig. As I said, it's a KD, basically, a variation of Kenny Dorsett's rig. So through the back of the eye, what you then do is you wrap around, I go around twice, as if I was tying a normal hair, then lift the wafter above, and I only go three times round underneath the hair. Flip that back over and back through the eye of the hook. And that is basically your rig tied. It couldn't be any simpler to tie. The whole idea of this rig is the mechanics. Now, tying it twice around first and then three times underneath the hair, as you can see, as it goes in, it's like that. As it comes out, boom. And you can see how aggressive that hook is as it drops, which is exactly what you're looking for. And that's why I only go three times underneath the hair, twice over the hair, three times underneath the hair. Just creates that mega aggressive angle. When the fish tries to eject it, boom, drops straight down. All you do then, swivel, size 8 swivel, leg clip swivel, and just a double overhand loop knot. Create a nice loop, and you're done. And it could not be any simpler. Now there's two key things with this rig. Firstly, the wafter. It needs to be balanced properly. So you want the hook laying on the lake bed and the bait just above it. It needs to be critically balanced. You don't want that hook lifting off the bottom. You want it just laid down like that, with the wafter just above it. Hook choice, covert dark, wide gape talon tip hooks. Now the reason I use this, twofold. Firstly, the gape. When you're using what I'd call a pinball rig, you want as big a gap between the shank and the point of the hook as you can get. You want to give it the best chance of tagging some skin when it's bouncing around inside the mouth. The second reason I use it as well is because it's talon tips. Now, when you've got a critically balanced bait, when it's laying on the bottom like that, it can, on occasion, lift up, lift out. Now, if you're using a straight point, there's a chance that it's going to get burred off. But with the talon tip, that's highly unlikely. So your hook's going to remain as sharp as when it went out there. The second important thing with this rig is how it sits in the water. What you don't want You don't want a rig that comes down like that straight. That is not what you're looking for at all. Again, the whole idea of this rig is to get the bait as far back into the fish's mouth as you can possibly get it. And naturally, the braid will come down, land, and the braid will, that's what you're looking for. This way, fish comes in, picks it up, he's got all this movement before he actually hits a lead. And so what you end up with, this will go probably between 2 and 3 inches back inside the mouth, which is perfect, because as soon as he tries to get it, it then starts bouncing around, pinballing inside the fish's mouth, and it's gonna tag something. So yeah, couldn't be simpler. That's the cotton rig.